fell right into their hands. A story was spun as steady wage and adventures, fight and terror in foreign lands. As the life of a soldier had thrilled and enticed him as Mother Job had done. He'd read and was told of the beauty of freedom that spread by our planes and our guns. After 2 years of service in Colchester barracks, transporting bullets and shells, through the ranks ran a murmur as the orders were given, excitement rose and it fell. But as they descended to Kandahar city, a grim silence fell over the plain. Shots of mortars rang in the distance like threats from a sky-turning crane. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced for refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on him as he was led away to the jail. And the weeks stumbled into each other, soon the months were passing him by. Nothing was leaving the compound but coffins and rockets tore through the night sky. Reports came daily of villages bombed to frighten insurgents away. Reports came daily of villages bombed, only bones and ashes remained. While these embers were smouldering, the story unfolded, led him to question the cause. All we have ever brought to this land are the scars and tissues of war. But as they're true to a close, he vowed he would never return. He told his captain who threatened and screamed, these thoughts and other soldiers' concern. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced, refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on him as he was led away to the jail. To resist or return to the front. When the villagers' cries and the general's lies, he made up his mind to confront. And on the day he walked out to the barracks to the squad, he shouts of support. In the face of treason, he laid down his reasons and proved the terrors of war. Soon the military tried to throw him in jail and they banned him from speaking his mind. But Joe Glenton continued to follow his conscience through the hard days and grit and the grind. Armed with only his story and all he had witnessed, each traveling gave his account. And a threat of arrest as he rose to address the crowds who gathered around. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced for refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on him as he was led away to the jail. After months of dispute and hounding pursuit, they caught him and brought him to trial. The judge rose to address the military court and sentenced Joe Glenton to jail. No medals or crosses of gold or of bronze are pinned to Joe Glenton's lapel. No handshakes of service for courage or conscience, instead condemned to rebel. He served his time to the prison clock's chime of 9 months that were buried and gone. Back out on the street and repentant, unbroken, determined to take the fight on. Well, he wasn't the first and he won't be the last to stand up and utter these tones. But the words of a rebel shaken and nerve them as other young soldiers were gone. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced, refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on as he was led away to the jail. Joe Glenton, he was sentenced, but the criminals dance free today. There were many before him, there'll be many after, no question instead of obey.